You're watching Reality Check. It has reached a point of breakdown in Rajasthan between Sachin Pilot and the Congress. The Congress believes that, contrary to what Sachin Pilot, in fact, what he told Sachin NDTV yesterday, that he has no intention of joining the BJP, that Sachin Pilot is acting in concert with the BJP. Consider today, when both sides confronted each other in court in Jaipur, as Sachin Pilot challenged the attempt to disqualify him by the Congress party by going to court. Representing him were two of India's most powerful lawyers, and perhaps some would argue the most highly paid, Harish Salve and Mukul Rohtagi. Mukul Rohtagi, as we know, has been a law officer under the BJP government, both lawyers considered very close to the regime. The Congress believing that, contrary to Pilot's claims, that he is still cobbling up the numbers and he is still trying to get to that magic number of 30 MLAs to unseat the Gehlot government. Now, numbers are crucial. The legal battle is crucial, but the numbers are crucial and the two are closely linked. How is that? Well, let's just put those numbers up on the screen. So, when Mr. Gehlot started off, as in before the revolt, he had the support of 122 MLAs, where the halfway mark of the house is 100. So he was 22 over, comfortable. Right now, our calculations suggest that he's reduced somewhere to 102, 103, 104, somewhere in that range now, just above the halfway mark of 100. So what is the Congress hoping to do in the event that they're able to disqualify these MLAs? Is that the strength of the house comes down. From 200, it comes down to about 180. The halfway mark then becomes 90. If you put that graphic up on the screen, we'll be able to understand how that works. That means that Mr. Gehlot, even with this 102, 103, is well over this new halfway mark of 90. And that makes the situation for him somewhat a little more comfortable. But of course, as we mentioned, all of this now is in court. You have Harish Salve, and you have Mukul Rohtagi facing off against Abhishek Manu Singhvi, who we are hoping is joining us and is about to come online any moment. But twists and turns in the political story continue. You have a situation now where on one hand, Sachin Pilot is accused of sabotaging the Congress. Now you have Hanuman Beniwal, an ally of the NDA, making an accusation on Twitter that Vasundhara Raje, senior leader of the BJP, is actually sabotaging the BJP, alleging that she is going around canvassing support for Ashok Gehlot, talking to MLAs close to her, Congress MLAs close to her. This is the allegation that Hanuman Beniwal has made. The BJP has rejected this allegation and so that is where it is all poised on the razor's edge. Let me go straight across now to Abhishek Manu Singhvi, who was representing the Congress just a short while ago. Abhishek Singhvi, thank you very much indeed for joining us. Thanks for your patience. Before we come to the legalities of it, Abhishek Singhvi, if I can just begin by asking you that, were you at all surprised when in court you found yourself up against Harish Salve and Mukul Rohtagi? Did that come as a surprise?
On the contrary, I would be surprised if it were not so. We are all colleagues at the bar. Every day we appear for the same side or against each other, almost more than once a day. And in matters like this, I would have been surprised if it were otherwise. So there's nothing to do with this. It's a commonplace for many of these matters.
The allegation here is that these are very high-powered lawyers who are very close to the present regime. And the fact that they are representing Sachin Pilot and the rebels is being seen as further evidence that there is a proxy BJP backing of this whole business, this entire Sachin revolt.
You know, Asan, as a lawyer and a professional, I can tell you that we have not yet included the fact that lawyers with a particular political leaning will also constitute defection under the 10th schedule. And I'd like to keep it that way, because I think lawyers ultimately do their job, do their duty. But there is plenty of other evidence, I think, before the speaker to suggest that the first part of the 10th schedule, which says voluntarily giving up their membership, has occurred. Yes. And I think for considering that in a show cause stage, at the moment he has made no decision, he has taken no view, but for issuing a notice and considering it, I think he doesn't need to go and include lawyers appearing as a reason. But okay, yes, but the speaker is a constitutional authority. He is the sole person tasked under the 10th schedule to decide it. I am the speaker as far as lawyering for him is concerned. And I think he is obliged to take a sober, reasoned, balanced legal decision.
I want to come to that in just
at the
second,
moment, he has done nothing. He has only issued a show cause.
Okay. I want to come to the legality of it in just a second. Let's just try to play for you another important player in all this, which is the Bharatiya Tribal Party. This is a small party. Their MLAs, not clear who they were backing all this while, but one of them told me that they are on their way to meet Mr. Gehlot. They're going tonight. They're going to meet him tomorrow morning. And that is likely to be good news, at least from Mr. Gehlot's perspective. Let's listen to an interview with the leader, the head of the BTP party, what they told us. We recorded this a short while ago.
Hey, apni logon ne spasht keh diya hai ki abhi bhi WhatsApp group mein ye bataya ja raha hai ki hum Gehlot ke saath hain. Kai log kehte hain ki Manya sir hain, वो जयपुर चले गए हैं. इस प्रकार की बातें सामने तो आ ही रही है और समाचार पत्रों में भी, और इन लोगों ने फोन पर भी स्पष्ट रूप से बता दिया है कि हम कांग्रेस के साथ. इस प्रकार उन लोगों ने बता दिया है. अभी तो बराबर पार्टी की स्पष्ट बातें जब सामने आ जाएगी तब पार्टी हरकत में आएगी और उनके बारे में सोचेगी कि क्या करना है, क्या नहीं करना है, क्या कार्रवाई की जाए, या पार्टी के साथ है या नहीं है. ये जब स्पष्ट बातें हो जाएगी
So the BTP leader there indicating that they are still inclined to the Congress but still waiting to make up their minds, always keeping that additional card free. Let me go back to Abhishek Singhvi. Abhishek Singhvi, is it true that Sachin Pilot also reached out to you for legal advice as someone who's a comrade of yours in the party?
Can you hear me, please?
Yes, I can hear you. We can hear you.
I think it would not be fair to distort that. He's a dear friend. I still think he's one of our most valued colleagues in the Congress. I think quite innocently, he had telephoned me 2 days ago seeking advice. And I jocularly told him that the honorable thing was to tell him that I could not talk to him because I'm advising the other side. And we both had a good laugh. And that was the end of it. So it was in that spirit that he called me. After all, we've known each other for a long time. And he wanted my advice, which he said he values. But it was not to. I was advising the speaker and a dispensation with which his views did not match.
Okay, fair enough. To the more substantial question of what is in court now. Now, essentially, from what I understand, the allegation is the speaker has found, Congress allegation, which the speaker has endorsed, that you essentially serve notice to Sachin Pilot and his MLAs, asking them to turn up at these CLP meetings of the Congress Legislative Party on 2 occasions. And the notice mentioned that failure to do so means that you are acting against the interests of the party. You are separating yourself from the party. And that since they didn't, they are liable for disqualification. What the petition of the other side argues is that simply not turning up for a CLP meeting doesn't necessarily mean that you're anti-party and that you can be disqualified.
Can I answer, please?
Yes.
Lots of misconceptions floating around, and we are not here today to get verdicts by judges or courts. I can only summarize what are the principles on our side, because ultimately the matter is sub judice and I'm not here to prejudge or second guess the matter. The judges will do it and the speaker will do it ultimately. The point number one, which is a misconception, is that the 10th schedule allows you to take action for disqualification only regarding what you have behaved in the House, voted this way or that way, whipped this way or that way. Now, that is a misconception which has been cleared by many, many judgments in the Supreme Court. That outside House activities, and I'm not at all opining about Mr. Pilot at all, that will be decided by a proper hearing and an order. But as a matter of law, non-intra-house activities can as well constitute. And specifically cases of health that non-attendance at party meetings can be. There is no necessarily about it. There is no one single straw which decides. But it can be a circumstance. Number two, the issue would be whether a speaker who is merely at the stage of a show cause and has yet to make up his mind and will decide on the merits and natural justice he must comply with, which he has, and given time, whether he can be interrupted by a court, by interim relief, etc. There again, according to us, and ultimately we are not the final people, the judges will decide. I'm only giving you a summary of my arguments. There again, according to us, the courts cannot, do not, and are prohibited by several judgments from interfering in the process prior to a speaker's decision. They cannot thwart, abort, or obstruct a process of decision making by the speaker.
Okay, but on the substantial point, if I may, on the substantial point, you would still argue that by these MLAs not turning up for these meetings, that itself is grounds for disqualification. Doesn't that seem a bit excessive?
I would argue nothing. I'm the speaker's counsel. The people who have complained may argue as the complaint states. And the speaker will hear the other side and take a decision. I am only answering your legal question. It is entirely possible for, in a hypothetical case, not this case, for a person to be disqualified for dealing with other party people, for not attending your own party meetings, etc. I am answering a question of law as a matter of possibility. Whether the people here are liable or not is something to be decided.
Okay, that's something, as you say, has to be decided. We'll have to wait and see how that goes. But certainly, it's going to be the battle of the legal heavyweights now in Rajasthan. Thank you very much indeed, Abhishek Singhvi, for joining us on the show tonight. Thanks very much. All right, let's now go on the phone line to someone who has emerged as an unlikely newsmaker in all this, Hanuman Beniwal. He's a Lok Sabha MP from Rajasthan. He's the leader of a regional party. And he has made a shocking allegation. Hanuman Beniwal ji, bahut bahut dhanyawad aap hamare saath jude. Aapne bahut gambhir aarop lagaya hai. Aapne kaha hai Vasundhara Raje ji, jo bhajpa ki neta hain, wo Ashok Gehlot ji ki madad kar rahi hain. और MLAs को कह रही हैं कि वो सचिन के साथ नहीं जाए. कांग्रेस MLAs से बात कर रही हैं वसुंधरा राजे. किस आधार पर कह रहे हैं आप?
मैंने ये आरोप लगाया है और पिछले एक सप्ताह से जो राजनीतिक घटनाक्रम राजस्थान के अंदर चल रहा है, पूरी भारतीय जनता पार्टी पर, अशोक गहलोत और पूरी कांग्रेस पार्टी आरोप लगा रही है, हमारे राष्ट्रीय नेतृत्व पे, प्रधानमंत्री जी पे, अमित शाह जी पे, बीजेपी पे और तमाम लोगों पर, भाई खरीद फरोख कर रहे हैं. और ऐसे समय में वसुंधरा जैसी वरिष्ठ नेता का कोई बयान नहीं आना. और आज ये बात कोई मैं नहीं कह रहा हूँ, मैंने पहले बीजेपी के अंदर ही बात करता था, मैंने संघर्ष किया, नई पार्टी बनाई, आज भी एनडीए के अंदर वहाँ एमपी के तौर पर मोदी जी के साथ हूँ. और तो मैंने आज आरोप लगाया, एक मैंने सीकर के विधायक का लगाया, एक नागौर के विधायक का, वो कांग्रेस के विधायक थे. तो सचिन पायलट के खेमे के अंदर जाने के बाद वसुंधरा जी के टेलीफोन पे दोनों विधायक अशोक गहलोत के खेमे के अंदर आ गए. इसके पुख्ता प्रमाण मेरे पास है. और वसुंधरा जी की चुप्पी और पिछला 20 साल का जो सिस्टम चल रहा है राजस्थान के अंदर गहलोत वसुंधरा गठजोड़ का, ये मैं ही आरोप नहीं लगा रहा हूँ, ये पहले भी आरोप लगे, चाहे बंगले का मामला हो, चाहे अभी सीएम के सलाहकार का मामला हो, पिछले सीएम के सलाहकार का मामला हो.
हनुमान जी,
मिला जुली का
मिलीजुली आप जो कह रहे हैं कि वसुंधरा जी ने एमएलए को फोन किया, आप कह रहे हैं आपके पास पुख्ता प्रमाण है, वो क्या प्रमाण है?
पुख्ता प्रमाण उन एमएलए के परिवार के लोग और उनके नजदीकी लोग हैं जिन्होंने ये कहा कि वसुंधरा जी मदद कर रही है अशोक जी की, इसलिए हम मदद नहीं करेंगे क्योंकि अशोक जी की सरकार गिरेगी नहीं और हम पायलट को छोड़ के वापिस आ गए. और वसुंधरा जी हमें टेलीफोन किया.
ये इस गंभीर आरोप का आपने देखा होगा, भाजपा ने आके उसका पूरा खंडन किया है, कहा ऐसा कुछ नहीं है.
देखिए साहब, मेरे व्यक्तिगत विचार है, मैं मेरी राष्ट्रीय लोकतांत्रिक पार्टी है उसका सुप्रीमो भी हूँ, मेरी खुद की, और मैं वहाँ प्रधानमंत्री जी के साथ हूँ, मैं भी चाहता हूं कि राजस्थान में अशोक गहलोत की सरकार जो अल्पमत के अंदर आ गई है, युवाओं को रोजगार नहीं मिल रहा, किसानों के कर्जे माफ नहीं हुए, कानून व्यवस्था चौपट हो गई और सचिन पायलट को मुख्यमंत्री बनाने की बात उस समय थी और जबरन अशोक गहलोत मुख्यमंत्री बन गए। उस समय भी सचिन पायलट को सपोर्ट किया था। 2018 के अंदर मेरे 3 विधायक आए थे, 3 और 2 निर्दलीय मिला के मैंने 5 MLA सचिन पायलट को सपोर्ट किए थे 2018 के अंदर। और 19 में मैं प्रधानमंत्री के साथ आया।
आप ये कह रहे हैं, आप ये आरोप लगा रहे हैं, आप कह रहे हैं आपके पास प्रमाण हैं, अभी तक आपने प्रमाण सामने नहीं रखे हैं। अगर वाकई हैं तो उन्हें जरूर सामने रखिए और देखते हैं इसमें कितनी हकीकत है, लेकिन द एलिगेशन इज सीरियस। हनुमान जी, थैंक यू वेरी मच इंडी फॉर ज्वाइनिंग अस। बहुत बहुत धन्यवाद आप हमारे साथ जुड़े। हनुमान बेनीवाल देयर, NDALI विद अ शॉकर of an allegation. We'll have a live BJP reaction to that in just a second. But before that, let's go to our other big exclusive, Digvijay Singh. The question is that this exodus of the younger generation of the Congress, be it Jyotiraditya Scindia or Sachin Pilot, is linked to the older guard. Are those like Digvijay Singh responsible, in a sense, for this exodus? I put this as my first question to the Congress leader. On this entire matter of Sachin Pilot's rebellion, if one were to call it that, I was looking at your Twitter handle. And from your Twitter handle, it seems fairly clear whose side you're on this. You seem extremely critical of Sachin Pilot and his revolt. You think he has no grounds for feeling aggrieved and for doing what he did? Because many would argue that it is the old guard, constituted of leaders with all respect like yourself, that have led people like Jyotiraditya Scindia and people like Sachin Pilot to revolt.
Vasu, it's a very strong charge against me. First of all, I'm not in charge of Rajasthan. And I have not said anything except I have posted what Sachin and Jyotiraditya ji have said on record. That's all.
No, you said that, but that clearly indicates that you're indicating how they've now turned their entire position. But the question really is, Mr. Singh, that why have they done that? Now, they claim in their own individual capacities, in their different contexts, that that's because that they were not given opportunities. They were stifled by their seniors. In the context of Jyotiraditya Scindia, he's named you and Kamalnath as the reason why, or at least a primary reason why, he left the Congress. And Sachin Pilot says similarly about Mr. Gehlot.
I would not like to go into that again. What I've posted on my Twitter handle is just what they had said about Mr. Modi,
yes,
Mr. Shivraj Singh Chauhan in Madhya Pradesh, and BJP as such. That's all. Now, it isn't all what I've said is in public domain. So what is so new about it?
No, that's fine. I'm simply asking you this, Mr. Singh. I'm saying if one were to look at the wider question here, do you think that this argument, which is being advanced by those like Jyotiraditya and now Sachin Pilot, and it is something that is finding resonance amongst other young leaders of the Congress party, that there is a problem in the Congress, that younger talent is being stifled by the older guard? Would you concede that at least?
But why do you forget that these very people who are leveling these charges were given opportunity by the Congress party, not by the BJP? They were made members of parliament at young age. They were taken into the central cabinet. They were given prominent position in the state Congress and the central working committee.
Sure.
So where is the charge?
Okay, you can watch a fuller version of that interview with Digvijay Singh online on ndtv.com. Let me go across now to Pawan Kheda, Congress spokesperson. We're also hoping to be joined by the BJP's Arjun Lal Meena, the Lok Sabha MP of the BJP from Udaipur. But we're trying to see if we can get him on the line as well. But at the moment, we have Pawan Kheda with us. Thanks for joining us, Pawan Kheda.
Thank you.
Pawan, if I can just start by asking you that tonight, as we speak, Is it fair to say that given everything that's happened in the past 24 hours, that you think it's now, I mean, the Congress believes it's a breaking point completely with Sachin Pilot. There's no way back from this now.
Vasu, the ball is in his court. What we believe or not is absolutely crystal clear, transparently available for everyone to see. We've said, repeatedly said, even yesterday we have said that our doors are open. So what we believe is absolutely there for everyone to see. Now, what we need to see, all of us need to see, is what he believes. What are his beliefs?
Open to his, would you still be, what I'm saying is that, so then you're not closing the door. You're still, I mean, were he to reach out, the door is still open for him.
Absolutely. And we made it very clear even yesterday. My senior colleague, Randeep Singh Surjewala, was very clear about what the Congress wants. Our doors are open. Mr. Ashok Gehlot and the central leadership, everybody has said clearly, if he wants to, I mean, the doors are definitely open for Mr. Pilot.
But you know, Pawan, on one hand, there's this allegation that it's Sachin who's sort of in cahoots with the BJP. And you just heard Hanuman Beniwal there on the phone line. He's alleging that actually Mr. Gehlot and Vasundhara Raje are acting in tandem.
No, that what Mr. Beniwal has said is for the BJP to clarify. I don't need to get into that because it's got nothing to do with our party. And I wonder why our MLAs would listen to Vasundhara ji and not to us and not to Ashok ji. So I don't want to get into that debate. Having said that,
right?
Well, there are enough reasons for us to believe that there was an attempt by the BJP to destabilize our government. We've seen what happened in Madhya Pradesh. We've seen what they keep trying in other states. So we have enough reasons to believe that. You know, too, BJP leaders in Rajasthan are in custody as we speak for plotting to destabilize our government.
But you don't believe, Pawan, that you don't think that Sachin Pilot is still in touch with the BJP, that, you know, let me just come back to you, Pawan. In fact, let me take that question to Mr. Meena, Arjun Lal. Meena is on the phone line with us. Meena Saab, बहुत गंभीर आरोप आप आरोप लगा रहे हैं कांग्रेस के अंदरूनी उस पर और यहां पर आपके सहयोगी दल के हनुमान बेनीवाल जी ने कहा है कि वसुंधरा जी गहलोत जी के साथ मिलकर काम कर रही हैं, गहलोत जी का मदद कर रही हैं।
हेलो,
हाँ अर्जुन लाल जी, मेरी आवाज आ रही है आप तक?
आ रही है सर, आ रही है।
हाँ, हनुमान बेनीवाल जी ने आरोप लगाया है कि वसुंधरा राजे गहलोत जी के साथ काम का मदद कर रही है।
देखिए सर, ये कांग्रेस पार्टी का आपसी लड़ाई झगड़ा है और इसमें जो पहले पीसीसी अध्यक्ष थे और उप मुख्यमंत्री सचिन पायलट और अशोक गहलोत साहब की आपसी लड़ाई है। अब इनका खुद के घर तो संभल नहीं रहा और दूसरे पे आरोप लगा रहे हैं। मैं समझता हूँ कि ये आरोप निराधार है। जी,
आरोप तो आप ही के सहयोगी लगा रहे हैं।
नहीं, अब वो उनका सोच है, लेकिन भारतीय जनता पार्टी एकजुट है। भारतीय जनता पार्टी केंद्र और भारतीय जनता पार्टी प्रदेश के जो नेतागण है हमारे, वो सारे मिल बैठ के कोई भी अगर बात आती है, अभी तो आपसी झगड़ा है उनका, अभी कोई मामला ही नहीं है। अब कोई बात आती है तो आप बैठ के ऊपर के जो लीडर है वो निर्णय करेंगे इसमें।
अच्छा, चलिए, तो आप कह रहे हैं कि ऐसी कोई बात नहीं है, बट सर्टेनली द स्टोरी इज टेकिंग विद एवरी ट्विस्ट अ न्यू टर्न। यू आर कंप्लीटली आउट ऑफ टाइम। थैंक यू सो मच फॉर जॉइनिंग अस अर्जुन लाल मीना जी। अनफॉर्चुनेटली वक्त कम था। पवन खेड़ा, एज ऑलवेज अ प्लेजर। दैट्स ऑल द टाइम वी हैव ऑन रियलिटी चेक। थैंक्स सो मच फॉर वॉचिंग। गुड नाइट।